Hello everyone, my name is Bethany, or Toscara, whatever you prefer, and today I'm going to be making something a little different. In the past, I have gotten requests, mainly from people on DeviantArt, to make some sort of art tutorial or process video on how I make my drawings. So today I'm finally following through on my word and making that video. So to start out with, the program I use is called GIMP, which stands for GNU Image Manipulation Program. It's basically like a free version of Photoshop, and it's available for both Mac and PC. It's easily the best free digital art program I've ever used. I also use a drawing tablet called the VisTablet Pen Pad. It's a cheap, flimsy thing, but it works for me. I got it for like $40 off of Amazon. It's pretty good, but yeah, it works. So my canvas size is usually anywhere around 2,000 to 3,000 pixels. Sometimes I go over 4,000 depending on how detailed I want my drawing to be. I have yet to figure out how to up the resolution in my drawing, so if anyone knows how to do that in GIMP, please let me know. That would be greatly appreciated. The canvas size in this drawing is about a little over 2,000 in width and about 2,500 in height. So here I've started off with a very rough sketch. That's what you saw me start out with in the beginning. And the rough sketch is where I break down the image in my head into simple shapes and lines, and basically block out the composition, especially if I plan on doing a background as well. And what you see me doing now is I've opened up a new layer over the rough sketch layer, and I'm now doing the clean sketch. So I'm just adding more detail and cleaning up the overall look, and this is what I'm going to be lining in later. My hardness for the clean sketch is set to 50%, and I'm using the basic paintbrush tool, and my dynamic is set to pressure opacity. So what pressure opacity does is, depending on how hard or light I press with my tablet pen, it will change the either thickness or the opacity of my stroke. So with pressure opacity, it just changes the lightness and darkness. And this also changes depending on other dynamics. The reason I sketch in red is because A, I like using the bright colors opposed to just sketching in gray or black, and B, I find it a lot easier, especially when you're doing your line art, to have your sketch be in a bright color so you can see it more easily. Usually when I'm doing line art, I just use black to start out with. So if my sketch is also in black or gray or just monochrome, then it makes it a little harder to distinguish the sketch from the line art. And this drawing I'm making here, this character is just a unicorn character I have. He's pretty simple to draw, which is why I chose him. And yeah, I'm just gonna speed up the rest of the drawing. Yay! Now that the sketch layer is done, I've opened up a new layer over the sketch layer for my line art. For line art, I'm using the same paintbrush tool, but my dynamics are set to pencil generic. I have my smooth stroke set to 100%, weight set to 20, and incremental is turned on as well. And my hardness is set to 50%. pressure sensitivity with my tablet is really important when I'm doing line art. I try to think about where more darker and defined areas are on my subject, and there I make the lines thicker. And for smaller details, I make the lines thinner. When I'm drawing a horse, I generally like to make the lines more simplistic. And the reason for that is when I do my shading, I like to rely on the shading and lighting to show the details, and I feel like the lines kind of get in the way of that. So I only add lines to the more defined areas like the nostrils and the eyes and other areas like that. Line art is probably my least favorite part of the process, but it's still very important to get right, and you really have to take your time with it so it doesn't look too messy. Really quickly, before I start my shading and all that, I'm just coloring in the lines using a darker version of the base colors below it. This just makes it look a little softer and more natural, and I don't really like the look of just plain black line art. I like it when the line art kind of melds into the coloring but still kind of stands out. Now I've opened up a new layer above all the others, and I've set it to multiply. This setting makes it so that no matter what color you put down on the canvas, it will automatically be darker than all the layers below it. This makes it perfect for shading. When picking a color for the shading, I try to think about what the environment is that's around my character. What is the light source? Where is it coming from? And what color is it? If it's the sun, then the light will give off a soft yellow. Light also bounces off your surroundings and back onto your subject. So if my character is sitting in, say, a field of green grass, the light will reflect off of the grass and onto the character, making some of the shading green. If I don't have a background, I have a little more freedom to shade in whatever color I want. In this case, I mainly try to pick a color that goes with the character's palette, but also contrasts in a way. If the character is mostly blue, you don't want the shading to be blue as well, but you also don't want it to be something that completely clashes. For example, I might pick purple. Purple is a really good color for shading characters, as it can be a warm or cool color. Of course, if your character is purple, then resort to something else. One book I look at for inspiration is called Color Drawing. In the book, the writer talks about color theory, composition, and things like that. Reading up on color theory is really, really helpful for shading. For this character, I've picked kind of a desaturated brown. In real life, it would be more of a bluish brown, but since this is a fantasy character that's just kind of floating in a void, so to speak, we have more freedom. For horses, I usually have some kind of reference for shading, which I will show here. I start by blocking the shading in, and then I go back and I use the smudge tool to blend it in. Really quickly, for the horn's texture, I've just taken an image off of the internet of a moonstone texture, then I've put it over the layer where the horn's color is, and then merged it down with the overlay setting. For highlights, I open up a new layer on top of the multiply layer, and I set it to soft light. Just like what I did with the shading, I use the light source to determine where the lighting will go. On horses, lighting works a little differently, so I also use a reference for that. Lighting is usually the last part of the drawing, so it also kind of acts as a touch-up stage, just making sure everything looks good together. So overall, that's basically how I create my drawings. Now, please note that this is just one style of drawing that I do, but it's one of my favorites, which is why I chose to record it over another. I hope you all found this helpful, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And thank you all so, so much for watching.